The rehab take 12 weeks.
I also never like to take my jacket in because I always forget it. I think I saw you guys right before, Coach. Hi, babe.
Hi.
Hello, boss lady.
I've arrived.
I like the high contrast, right?
And he got smacked so hard in church that he never went back.
I guess we're going plan B. Spring. Like, today is spring. Rubbing on things they shouldn't rub on. Oh my God, y'all. I was about to rip all these cords off my filming setup. One cord went missing and today's video is sponsored by Thrive Market. If you have not heard of Thrive Market, they are an online membership-based grocery store with guaranteed savings on every single order. There are two membership options, monthly and annual. If you pay monthly, it is $12 a month. If you pay annually, it's $5 a month, which is a savings in itself. I did my due diligence and I made sure to check out the prices, and they are not kidding when they say they have the low prices on these products. And they have a large variety of products, so whether you have a specific diet hairy lifestyle or you just live too far away from a healthy grocery store, Thrive Market could be a great option for you. Your annual membership sponsors a free one for a family in financial need, student, teacher, veteran, nurse, or first responder. Oh, I love this. Now for a little haul, I got the Chomp salt and pepper venison sticks. These are a jerky stick that Chris wanted to try. You get 10 sticks in the box and they're huge. And I saw the widest selection of flavor options in the Chomp line. This is a little bit for both of us. It is grilling season and I wanted to use the beef tallow as our cooking oil. I heard it's really good. We're gonna try that out on our Blackstone. It's like coconut oil where it's solid in the jar and then when it's hot, it's all nice and oily. And on the note of oil, I love Truffs oil. This is the black truffle oil. They also have the white truffle oil on Thrive. Great on salads, and I love anything truffle. I also love fig spread on my bagels, on my toast. It's just good. And summer is the season for figs. And I saved quite a bit of coin. I took a screenshot. I saved $29.38. And because it was my first order, I got to pick one of the free gifts. So I'll show you guys what options I had. I did go with the high protein on the go set, which included two sticks of the original beef flavor for the Chomp sticks. Chris also liked those, so that was nice to be able to sample that. And two protein bars. I personally love a grocery delivery situation because I'm already running around, and if I want certain products, they're only available at certain stores. I don't want to run around the world. Have it show up to my door. Thank you so much. Orders over $49 ship free. If you want to maximize your savings and try Thrive Market out for yourself, you can click my link at the top of the info box to get 30% off your first order, as well as your free gift with purchase, which is worth up to $60. If you do not make back your $60 annual membership in your savings, Thrive will credit you the difference to your account. Talk about standing on business. Are we back with another vlog? Hello. It is the start of a new week, and I figured I'd take you guys along for this week to start off June right. I got sick in May, so the May vlog was filmed, but it got real PC and choppy, so we're just gonna run it back. Funny enough, the last time I filmed, I was standing here waiting on a Pest Now appointment to do their monthly checks, right? I'm also doing the same thing right now. But luckily, Chris is working from home today, so y'all can see this gigantic tripod right now. I got the house driveway cam up so I can keep an eye and put the dogs away before, you know, the ring of the doorbell, aka triggering my furry security system. The dogs have an interesting food routine right now where Callie eats like on a pretty good schedule, while Yuna, being the grown older sister firstborn dog, also a diva for those who have been keeping up, eats on her own routine. She eats at like 3 p.m. and midnight. Still gets two meals in, but she wants to eat when she wants to eat. While Callie's like, I'm starving. You have never fed me. What's taking so long? That kind of customer. They do a half and half of Spot and Tango and Stella and Chewy. That's been our go-to for a year now. And because I got nails, I always use a little thumb scraper to open my cans. I hate waiting around for appointments with the time slot, whether it be Verizon or our pest service or yard service or whatever. I'm like, can y'all give me like 1 hour y'all gonna show up in? I know it's for the flexibility, but still, I got anxiety. I need to go about my day. Also, who else plays a lo-fi for their dogs? I know I do. This is what we sounding like. Hold up. Keeps the vibes up, keep the ADHD moving. Callie's like, come on, it's brekkie. Get the brekkie right. I put the supplements in. It suddenly became a take care of my dog vlog. Man, my protein powder is not supposed to be here. It's kind of a reminder that I should probably drink protein shakes, but Instagram knows, but I had a craving the other day. I had some beef pasta, hamburger helper. Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. It hits when you want it. If y'all got a Lazy Susan and you guys don't have these clear triangular Lazy Susan bins, y'all need to get some. I try to put y'all on during the panorama. You still got a bunch of stuff in there, but you can, you know, take out the bin as needed and clean and nothing spilling or falling down. It's Lazy Susan approve.
Truly, Susan be working harder than most people in this house.
I'm gonna tell you right now, she gonna act brand new if I look like I'm filming whatsoever. So we're gonna pretend like we're not. All done? May have to go to the pet store to restock because we low. So it's Monday, but this weekend, the girls were here and I finally put in motion to some of the spring cleaning things. You know how everyone in the house got certain drawers that you need to handle or certain things you need to put on Marketplace. That's what we were doing. Certain clothes you need to donate. So my trunk is full of clothes we need to drop off into a donation situation. Chris already cleaned out. Both kids already cleaned out. I was too busy folding laundry to do my half, but there's certain drawers in my dresser, specifically my top drawer that's never been right. So I'm trying to figure out a new storage solution. I might get a new dresser because I've had that dresser for like 7 years. I moved from the townhouse with it. So there's a lot of things I want to figure out this week, and it's a finally figure out, but I was talking about it because I'm selling some of these like lunch bowls and like little Our Place bowls. I put them on Marketplace. So there'll be some little piles of things that people are coming to pick up. New month, new calendar. It's clean and cute right now. It won't be. I'm actually filming a fridge clean out today. So I'm going to do that. Oh, look at the posture. Posture check. Posture check. Thank you to the posture corrector. I need to put that thing back on. Come on, ADHD. Someone's coming to pick up plants within the next hour because I sold some of my extras. Some of these plants, you know, multiply. So I end up with a bunch of baby plants and then I end up selling them in local plant groups and stuff because, you know, side hustles are side hustling. Plus, I like having more space and give y'all a glance at a few of my pride and joys. The house at the top is better known as jail. That's where all the new plants come or some old plants. That's my only new plant. It's weatherproofed, seal in. That's from IKEA. All of these things are from IKEA. IKEA cabinet, attached with grow lights. This one's weather sealed, and they all have humidifiers magnetically mounted or sit in some places so I can keep an eye on them. And it syncs to my phone, so I know exactly what's going on. These are the ones being picked up today. There's a freebie. All right, that's your plant snippet for the day for those who care and for those who just like to be nosy. I brought my camera. I did not put a memory card in. Genius mommy. But I'm taking the kids to school, as you can see by Yaves and Mia Moo.
It's me.
And I have a nail appointment today, so I was trying to take you guys along for that. So, we're gonna have to stick to the iPhone for a little bit. It's in my computer slot. Ugh. Kids have to be at school between 9 to 9:15. Well, technically 9:05 to 9:15. This is my second to last morning drop off for the school year. Ava's graduation is in a few days. I mentally can't. I can't. But today's a nail day. Yes, ma'am. 4 weeks grown, maybe five. I'll count it out later. I think they're five. By typically 4 weeks at least. And I'm gonna cut them back down short since we are boxing, but I can keep the same length that we had previously. I'm gonna do a new set because my natural nails have grown the heck out. All right, we just parked. We got a little time to chat. I'm actually gonna text my nail tech and let her know I'm early. She has a baby and we want to make sure we're keeping her on schedule of what she needs to do and not interfering with the baby. But as I was saying earlier, I might keep the same nails, which is three coats of like a sheer nude polish. Something with the beach. I forget what it's called. Something with the beach. But it's real pretty. It's like my go-to nude. And I had it for May. And I already had some pretty fun nails for all the months leading into May because I was traveling so much. I don't know. I might do the same thing. But she also got some new magnetic polishes that I want to look at the swatches for since the last time I was here. I have plants in my trunk in a bag, in a box, in a bag because I'm meeting up with someone
in the same city around the corner and also picking up souffle pancakes after my appointment. Did I use a dessert cafe as the meetup point? Yes, I did. Let me show you guys my sustenance for today, since I'd leave the house, you know, 8:40, probably won't be back till 1:30, and I gotta leave the house again at 2:55 to pick up the kids from school. So yeah, thank goodness it's a day that Chris is not in office. He's working from home.
Y'all ain't gonna look over here because it's dusty, it's dirty, and it needs to be sprayed down and wiped down for sure. And that's on Christopher. Snacks of the day, I got this Go Macro bar, like a sample. Let's hope for the best. And then we got this peach Trader Joe's bar and then blue raspberry gushers. I might be wearing the same outfit from earlier this week too, because these loungewears are what I live in. Tastes like nougat, but like powdery nougat. I definitely like wafer protein bars better. I feel like this is what eating moist Play-Doh would taste like.
I already did mine before.
I think it's almost 5 weeks. It's very long.
Really? You have 5 weeks?
Yeah.
5 weeks or 5 weeks?
I think so. Right. So I came beginning of May.
Stop by the Japanese cafe to get my souffle pancakes. Oh ho ho, I've never gotten them to go before. I'm about to crush these. I also got spicy salmon onigiri. I got less than 10 minutes before my plants get picked up, and then I'm on the way home. So I should be home by 1:30.
It is wash day. So number one, the blow dry wasn't bad. Number two, my purple shampoo really be eating it up. Like, really? There's some pieces in the bag. Look at that. Brassy wear. The Amika shampoo. Girl. It still like lathers up, you know? I've been trying to do every other wash with it because I get a little too addicted to it. Just wanted to check in and say, did my purple shampoo do it? Yup. Let's talk about it. See, latte toaster. I opened these up to show me already. Whew. Yeah, but I gotta show you another pair. These are already been out. These, I believe, are called something in Friends. I don't remember the hell they call. Legend, Browns, whatever. But these are so different, right? Because this tone is lighter and warmer. And this is like a cream base with this like taupey color. Well, this is a pure white base with the tan and the black. Do I keep both? This is the more recent release, so I am kind of inclined to keep these. They're both very comfy. These are mids, these are highs. Which one would you keep? Pair number one, taupe. Pair number two, latte.
I got them for retail. This girl got a bath today. Because as you can see, she's shedding all over my stuff. Oh, what is that hanging out your mouth? What is that? Is that a blooper?
If I stop. She just ate her dinner. She got the itis. You can see her blinking it off.
Girl, you better get your hand back. Tell me you're the baby of the family without telling me you're the baby of the family, huh?
You're so crazy. I don't know what to do with you, huh?
Y'all ever get to a parking space and it took so long to get into the parking space that you don't want to leave the parking space? I'm at a shopping center that has our new boxing class that, like, the new location opens in like 4 days. Had to come exchange out Chris's gloves. He needed a different size for his gloves, so did that. Did I heat up my breakfast this morning
to then promptly not eat it and get ready instead. Yes. Yes, I did.
I would like it to be known, for the record, that Kehlani's After Hours has me in a chokehold.
Kehlani is my favorite singer. Saw her in concert. Ah, you combine that with Move Your Body by Nina Sky? How dare? How dare? But then she had the nerve to take that and combine it with Cater to You and release it on Spotify. So when it comes on, my inner child, my older woman come together and they go,
switch to little loungewear tee, kept the cargos on. Cause I feel like the rest of the day is gonna be more chill. I wanna be comfy. It is 1:48. Chris is working until 3, but he's working from home. So we might run a little errands later. We need to pick up his dry cleaning. And I need to buy a white tee for Yave. Specifically one from Zara, I think. Cause I want a crisp white tee for her graduation. Cause she has like a shirt that she's wearing over it. And you'll just see like, you know, a nice brand new, fresh off the rack, them franchise boy. White tee. I bling in my white tee. Surfing's in my white tee. Hair is up now in whatever conundrum it want to be in. I got mangoes. And I figured, for those who have not experienced the mango, one, I'm very sorry. Maybe don't like mangoes, also, my condolences. Or just don't know how to pick a good mango. There are two types of mangoes. These are the same type of mango, obviously. But these are yellow mangoes. They're smaller, more oval, less round. The more standard mango, the emoji mango, is red and green for the most part, a little bit yellow. Also sometimes known as the champagne mango. This is the mango you get if you want one that has less texture. Dare I say less pulp? It's not pulp, but you know, like the mango hairs. You want that smooth bite and you want super sweet, yellow mangoes. You want more of that sweet, tart, tangy, sweet, red and green mangoes. So I like yellow mangoes a lot. It's one of the best things Thai people combined. Mangoes and sticky rice, and obviously, need I say more, top tier combinations. And I figured since I was about to cut up some mangoes for a snack while I'm editing, I would show you guys how to pick a good mango, because the other day I let the store pick me out a mango and it was not a good mango. It still has some green on it. You can tell this was gonna be a stiff mango. But one way to tell if a mango is sweet and ready is by the top. You can kind of see it on this one, but there's like that little sheen, little syrup. When you see that at the stem, she's good, she's sweet, she's ready. If you don't see that, it looks dry, like your elbows in my eczema, you don't want that one. You don't want that one. But I think a lot of people who have to pick the produce don't know. I figured if that's the case, maybe some of y'all don't know. My mom, real G, you know, she hold it in her hand, better knife skill. She just peels off all the skin, then cuts it into, you know, like pineapple. It's gonna do verticals that I can munch on like orange peels. You can see the difference. This one's like perfect. This one's a little early. Mm-hmm. Don't eat the skin. I am testing, and not really really testing, just decided to wear it. Was the Fenty sunscreen, tinted sunscreen. Not sure how I feel about it. I'm not sure if it's gonna earn its own wear test yet, you know what I mean? I usually don't pre-test things. Not sure. I know I got the right shade. I got shade 3 because that's what coordinates with my normal foundation shade, but I don't know. I'm wrapping my head around it. Maybe it gets a YouTube short. Christopher's here. Sunroof is open. We're heading to get gas. Do you guys remember in the last vlog when I took you flower shopping? I couldn't make a decision. ADHD was ADHDing. I went back with Christopher maybe a week or two later and we picked out our plants for our driveway pots. It's a tricky spot because we get full sun. My side of the garage, more so than Chris's, gets full sun. So sometimes his flowers look better than mine. This year I decided to add a pot in the center. Went to Target, got a pot, grabbed some annuals, put it together like a little bouquet and put it in the pot. That one's thriving. Got my angel wings, got some purple, some pink, some white flowers. We typically stick to petunias because they're the only ones that last. But this year we got this pretty mixed bundle. Yellow, blue, pink, purple. Beautiful. It died. The sun has roasted it and I've been watering the same schedule as all my other stuff. And they just weren't gonna do it. They just weren't ready to survive in the conditions that we needed to put them through. So we probably need to grab more flowers today. Maybe on the way back from dry cleaners, depending on what time it is. I don't know. They're looking a little crisp. They're a little bacony. They're a little bleach blonde. So the shirt's gone. We're having an issue because I either get Ava sleeveless or I have to go find it somewhere else. So
It even says something on it, technically. But small.
Still out. Went to Nordstrom Rack to look for shoes because Nordstrom didn't have the style we were looking for. They had like a heavier version, so.
They feel lighter or heavier? There's a mirror too.
Kind of nice having this little corner. Hit it. Hit it. Oh, I actually didn't mean hit it. Okay, that's enough. All right, then we're switching the camera back to me. Said I don't even know what size shoe I wear anymore. Those are 12s? Okay. So maybe the ones at Nordstrom that you tried were 12s? Or she gave you the 11 and a half first? Something in your hair. Got you. But the box is 12. Okay. If y'all don't know, Cole Haan makes like the comfiest lightweight shoes ever. My favorite pair of like dressy sneakers I have were all beige, sole beige leather. That I got really lucky one time at Nordstrom. They were on clearance. Can't find them again in that colorway because they were probably limited edition. But now this man's walking around without his shoes on. Now it's the battle of the white sneakers. Two Cole Haans versus a non-Cole Haan. This is a Cole Haan though. One of those aren't. But this one is all white with a beige tag, the brown tag, and those are all white, all whites. Did he just put one of each shoe on? Yes, he did. Do you want to put the Cole versus a Cole? Or which one's your favorite between those two? Because that's a Cole and this is a Cole. Granted, these are very similar, but I don't know if one's lighter than the other. That one looks lightest. You like those more? We're in a parking garage at Nordstrom Rack. How many shoes did we buy, Christopher, out of trying on the whole show?
We pre-ordered 2 pairs of shoes.
We bought none. We bought none. We have no bag, but it's because they're cheaper on Amazon.
Yes.
So we did what normal people would do.
You try them on, you cross-reference the best price.
We didn't come knowing they were cheaper on Amazon.
Mission accomplished. I'm not sure. This is efficient, optimum.
So how mad would you have been if we went to Nordstrom, which we did, regular Nordstrom, non-rack, full price, Cole Haans, if you bought them full price, then went and found out Amazon got them for $80.
Then I would return them. Would you be mad?
You wouldn't feel emotionally enraged.
No.
I would. He's very happy with the experience. He's a great shopping trip. Don't gotta carry. He like, didn't gotta buy nothing.
No, you're just listing positives.
You wanted Adidas slides because yours are getting old.
Yeah.
So he would have bought those. But guess what? Only size 18. Who wears a size 18? Ugh. But yeah, we gotta go DSW at some point, probably. Or I gotta grab them online for him because that's usually what I do. Because Adidas sandals are great if you get them in cloud foam. If you don't get them in cloud foam, they're hard because they're shower shoes. If you get cloud foam, you can't wear them in water because it absorbs water, obviously, foam, cloud, cushion. But if you want black in his size, cloud foam, and then even on top of that, I usually get him the black on black ones, that's a DSW or an online purchase. And that's how much your wife loves you, because I actually do it, even if it's not on discount, versus just grabbing you a little hard pair and be like, all right.
I can do it. They'll probably show up white or camo, but I can do it.
That means you can't do it.
I'll have slides. All I need is slides. It doesn't matter. Like,
why didn't you buy the blue ones then?
Huh?
Why didn't you buy the blue ones?
I don't want.
Oh my god! There was blue in your size.
I don't want blue ones, so I'm gonna attempt to get black ones. Mm. But if they show up wrong,
I'm pretty sure you just said that you would wear white or camo.
Yeah.
There was camo at the store. You were holding them.
But you said the logo was too big.
I said the only thing is you usually wear ones with stripes, not the big Adidas spelled out on your toes. I just said a fact and you said, We're going to dinner. We're going to go try a restaurant and so it's called New. I want to say we're going to go to a new restaurant, but it's N-U-E and it's from the same owners of Chasing Tails, which is like a seafood restaurant around here, but it's like they call it an elevated Vietnamese cuisine restaurant. So more of like a higher end Vietnamese cuisine. So
They take your favorite tried and trues and kind of elevate it with different ingredients. We'll see. We'll see. It says it's not too busy yet. It's Friday night, though, and I don't like being places at 5 at night.
Yeah, it may start to get busy, though.
Let's see if we can get... We 8 minutes away. Should I join the wait list? Why? Why are we doing things like this? The bus is coming for us. Oh, my God. Oh, look. New townhouses. Want to guesstimate? 90% are sold already. That's what the sign said. 1.1 in Tysons? No.
They don't look that big. 1.
They're not. Okay, I can guarantee you they're under 2,500 square feet for sure. Under 20. Mm-hmm. Or under 2,000. Max 2,100. Maybe the big floor plan, 2,300. But I'm going to say starting at 1.6.
I'm pro people. If I ever run for anything, then I will guarantee anybody's listening's vote. And I think they're 1.1, and you could probably negotiate them down.
You can't negotiate a new build.
If you name drop Christopher
Brown. Anyway, I've been prepping Chris for the Chris Brown concert, as I told you guys. So we're on track 3 of the set list.
Christopher Browning, yes.
Christopher Browning, your cousin. Cousin Chris. The set list is released now because he had a Detroit show already. So we are on number 3 out of the whole concert. We have work to do. And I will update you guys in a second
so
about the cost.
So far, so good. I like this brown kid.
Okay. You're going to get us in trouble with your cousin. Okay. So there are 3 models to the townhome. And yes, we are waiting for our table digitally right now. 3 models. Is your guess for the low, mid, or high tier one? Would you like descriptions of how many bedrooms?
Sure.
The lowest model has 3 bedrooms, 1,600 square feet, 2-car garage, 2.5 baths.
Okay.
So our house in a townhouse, same description. 2.5, 3 bedrooms, 2-car.
I think.
In Tysons.
That's 1-1.
That one's 1.
Okay.
That one's 1. Starting at 1. So which means it's 1-1 after taxes. Okay. So you're not wrong. What is the mid-tier one, which has 3 to 5 bedrooms, 2.5 baths to 4.5 baths. And we're using just the from price, right? You know how, like, when you add more, it's more. Yeah. Still 2 cars, 2,800 square feet. 28.
That's 1.6.
It is 1.5. It's 1.475. Okay. Yeah, okay. So close, yeah. Close, close, close.
That's
close.
A bargain.
That is not a bargain. Okay. Top tier one, 3 to 5 bedrooms. Same amount of 2.5 to 4.5 baths. Still a 2-car, but the square footage is largest, of course. Probably excessive for a townhouse. 3,140. 350 more square feet. Than
basically the same one, but with add-ons, probably. Like,
well, a different floor plan.
Yeah. But, like, built the same.
I think they're going to put the biggest ones on the corner because they have more windows. Mm-hmm. So
that...
Starting at...
And I think this is, like, 1.65, 1.7.
1.59.
Oh, really?
Yeah.
So, like, roughly the same.
Yeah. Okay. So, when you said 1, you had the lowest model correct. And when I said 1.6, I had the highest model correct. So, we were both right. And that sucks. So, because we want one person to be right.
Well, I was, you thought I was crazy. And mine was accurate.
Well, the thing is, you said 1. You said 1, but I said the square footage was going to be trash, which is our square footage. 1,600, trash. Trash for a new build. Ours is from 1970s, let's be real.
For us viewers and me, it's chump change.
You going to pay the property tax on that? Because I'm not paying the county tax on that. Every time our county tax go up, our mortgage go up $50, I'm sweating over here. Okay, sweating. I don't like it. Good morning, y'all. It is Saturday. It is a non-girl weekend, aka the girls are with their dads. Put on some glowy sunscreen because I really feel like I want to amp up the dew today just because the bottom half of my face. It's a little drier. I'm going to keep it simple. Just do some eyebrow gel.
let the skin speak for itself. I tested out the Fenty sunscreen, tinted moisturizer sunscreen, I should say. Tinted moisturizer, SPF 30. I didn't put it in the holder, you know, it has like the purple holder that you like take your regular sunscreen out. You can just buy it just like this. I did not like this. I didn't like it at all. The shade is right. So for my twinsies who are looking for it, it is shade 3 because they have charts that compare your foundation shades. I'm shade 240. 3 works. I like how you can see the product at the top of the pump when you pump it out. I did not like it because it got really cakey. I wore it for 9 hours yesterday. Didn't do a wear test specifically, but when I went to go shower after dinner and all that, it was crummy, like in the whole center of my face. So not for the textured gals. I have some abstract earrings on right now. And Chris was like, what is that? I was like, I don't know, to be honest. That piercing, like I can do whatever I want to it because I got that when I was a baby. But the other two, if I don't keep something that I can sleep in because they're fresher, they get cranky. So I can wear big ones on my main piercing. Today we are rocking Fleur Missing Person. I was considering mixing, but since I'm gonna wear my Real Radiance body oil sunscreen, little glowy sunscreen for the body, we go into the farmer's market. You like my farmer's outfit? Y'all can see it. It's just some linen pants from Hollister. I have the same ones from Princess Polly. The Hollister ones are just a different tone. Princess Polly's are a little bit more pinky taupe. This one's like more cool tone. Baby Tea by Nudes. I have these in 2 colors. I have so many of their products. It's crazy. All my pajamas and such. Ooh. How about this? How about a little? I can put the other tote bag in here just in case I get a lot of things. But this farmer's market we're going to, we have closer ones. We do. The 40 Minute South one is all day. It's like till 4 p.m. Other ones close at noon. This one has like food trucks, food stands. People bring out their grills. They make it food. I want some good lunch. So we're hoping for the best there. I'm gonna style these bangs a little bit because I haven't yet. I just woke up. I usually like to wear lighter colors to the farmer's market. But I already put the shirt on and put my deodorant on, so we're committed. Going to the farmer's market. Ooh. All right, there we go. More balanced. I got an upside down ripped bag of Chex Mix for the ride. Honey, we don't have sunglasses. I wanted to grab the ones by the front door.
Okay.
I don't know where half my sunglasses went. I'm quite sure they should be somewhere else if they are not. These are the ones from Pretty Little Thing, my little cheapo $8. I think they got them on Shein too. Filled with sunscreen spray and sand. And they're fine, but that wasn't what I was going for. I was going for classy baddie, you know, and that's not classy baddie. I do have some new Desi sunglasses on the way. Y'all gonna be sick of me! Thank you, sweetheart.
You're welcome.
We're dusty. Did you clean yours and not clean mine?
I didn't clean mine. Like, they were already clean.
They were not clean.
No.
Pause. No, it's fine. I got eyeglass cleaner. You know the situation happens way too much when I have cleaning solution and situation for our sunglasses. Here's the minis too.
Whatever was in my car, yeah.
They are minis. I wonder whose were the originals. These are probably the originals because they're more scuffed up. So I had the minis, right? Smoked minis, previously known as the high key minis, now known as the blueprints. And then he kept taking them.
I knew. Why can't you just tell an uplifting version of the story?
What would like, mean a fraudulent?
I liked your sunglasses. Fraudulent. And I wanted some as well.
So yeah. Then, where did they go?
What do you mean, where?
With you.
If you're not wearing them, then...
How can I wear them if I come downstairs? You're already wearing them. Is that fraudulent or is that accurate?
That's called, like... You know, over time when you settle in a place, squatter's rights type of thing.
No, it's not. Hang them up. I come down to get them. They're gone.
You didn't wear them over a 30-day period. Therefore, they're...
You wore them every day one summer. Every day. You don't even take them off when you go indoors.
That's how that works.
I had to buy him a pair. Anybody tell you that this is not the best piece of Chex Mix, they lying.
So we ended up going to the wrong location per we usually do. Then we found the one we wanted to go to. It's more in Fredericksburg. And that one closed at 1. So we got there like at 12:35. So a lot of things are packing up already, but we got our peach lemonade. We're gonna try our food while it's hot. Getting a bites in. Mac and cheese. No. This is elote. It looked like mac and cheese for a second. So we got elote. Loaded pulled pork mac and cheese. Let's stir that up. And Chris got 2 meats.
And you're gonna have the vegetable.
Ah! The sauce is, this is spicy. What is tangy? Yeah, tangy's good. I'm glad they gave you utensils.
I grabbed them.
I have utensils in my car, but thank you. I was just saying, business-wise, they never give utensils. So I was happy for that, but if you got utensils, then.
Sausage is good.
Is it spicy?
A little bit.
You just go on top of there. I'll scoop it up before. And I also got mini donuts. It's in this box. The box is on fire right now, but I'll show you guys just in case it doesn't look good. So I did a half a dozen. One side to the other, we got powdered sugar, plain glaze, and strawberry glaze. They're slight. $8. $8, yes. But we love to support desserts. There was also a corgi macaron table. Let's try the pork. That's what's on your sandwich. Wanna try the mac and cheese? Got that creamy. I like a creamy mac and cheese rather than like a charred or a chunky. I like a well thick creamy sauce mac and cheese. Give me 4 or 5 cheeses. It's the weekend and there's like 25 different house signs on the street. We look presentable enough to be a couple in their 30s who potentially are moving. Not. I hear people do that for fun on the weekends, and we don't do this too often, but it would be nice to see what the prices are going for in different areas. You know, research. Very limey. Level of like heavy, I like heavy mayonnaise. It's more lime juice than I've ever had. But I feel like people can tell that we're not from this area. I don't know why. I thought my farmer's market fit was great. I feel like people look at us funny. Do you guys feel like that when you travel places? Cause I don't know. I feel like we stick out like sore thumbs. I specifically wear sunglasses to farmer's markets so people can't see where my eyes are going because I have social anxiety. Medicated and all, here we are. I'm still like, I don't want to make eye contact too long because then like some people want to give you a sample or whatever, but I don't want to seem too interested in something because I don't know how to back out of something I'm not interested in. So sunglasses keep me at a good distance where I can look and read the signs without accidentally sending the wrong intentions or signals. Oviho. We back home. It was hot, y'all. Really, really hot. But I think that's it for today's, this week's vlog. I hope to give you guys another one this month. Thank you for spending the week with me. I hope you guys had fun. Basically being the fly on the wall, seeing what we're up to, sitting in on the combos. Millennial heart, love you so much. Don't forget to check out Thrive Market if you are interested. You can use my link down below at the top of the info box to get 30% off your first order, as well as the free gift with purchase worth up to $60. And that's all for me. I don't know how to sign out for these videos yet, so thank you guys for watching, and I'll catch you guys in the next vlog.